Political allies. They are political allies, right?
That's true. That's true. All right. We're not yet ready to resume, I think. So, yeah, Linda and Adele.
Mr. Demetrio.
Go. We're going back to the trial now. Okay, let's resume the coverage.
Who is your next witness? Please put him on the witness stand. Put her on the witness stand. Put him on the witness stand and swear him.
Mr. President.
The gentleman from Pampanga.
Yes, Mr. President. Just a clarification. Will there be other Supreme Court employees who will be testifying today? Or?
I don't know.
May the defense counsel.
As of today, none, Your Honor.
So this next witness is not from the Supreme Court?
He's not from the Supreme Court, Your Honor.
Yes, Mr. President, may I just make a manifestation?
Yes.
Before we proceed with the next witness. Mr. President, earlier it was a witness from the Supreme Court that came before us. I would like to stress, I have no issue with the defense, Mr. President. My issue is with the Supreme Court. I was told, Mr. President, that the previous witness was subpoenaed, and therefore, Bayuga, Attorney Bayuga, was here on the strength of a subpoena. Previously, Mr. President, a court process server was likewise subpoenaed by this court. Yet, the Supreme Court refused to honor the subpoena. And therefore, the witness did not appear. Mr. President, my concern here is we now have a situation wherein the Supreme Court decides when it will honor our subpoena and when it will ignore our subpoena. Again, this is not an issue between whether it's before the defense or the prosecution, Mr. President. This is an issue between this impeachment court, which has the sole power to try and decide impeachment cases, and the Supreme Court, which is an institution that is held accountable by this impeachment court, Mr. President. The only check on the possible excesses of the Supreme Court, Mr. President, is in this impeachment court. My fear, Mr. President, is now the only check is now being checked by the entity that is supposed to be checked. I don't wish for any ruling, Mr. President, at this point. I'm just making this manifestation. And hopefully, we may be able to find a solution. Because we will be calling the Supreme Court employee, or she will return tomorrow, Mr. President, if the Supreme Court allows her to return.
Well, I guess when the time comes for a rebuttal evidence, if the prosecution would want to ask any of the employees of the Supreme Court to appear, then we will equally issue a subpoena and trace out that problem at the proper time.
In this connect, along this line, Your Honor, may we be permitted? Only 1 minute statement,
yes,
Your Honor.
Proceed.
We have here a copy of the resolution referred to on February 14, 2012, Your Honor. And it provides, among other things, last portion, in some Philippine law rules and prohibit the disclosure of confidential or privileged information under well-defined rules, Your Honor. At the most, basic level and subject to the principle of committee, members of the court officials, employees may not be compelled to testify on matters that are part of internal deliberations and actions of the court in the exercise of their adjudicatory functions and duties, while testimony on matters external to their adjudicatory functions and duties may be compelled by compulsory processes, Your Honor. I'm just reading from this.
At any rate, I was informed by the Office of the Legal Counsel that Ms. Bayuga was also subpoenaed on February 1st upon the request of the prosecution. And she complied. She appeared here on February 1st in response to the subpoena issued to her. So maybe the matter that was the subject of the her examination today, as well as then, are not considered confidential by the Supreme Court. So, proceed.
With the kind permission of the Honorable.
Mr. Witness.
Sumayo po kayo.
Tayo po. Pakitaas lang po ng kanang kamay. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?